the Kyrgyzstan capital, Bishkek's National Hospital for Infectious Diseases. Here, infants with respiratory illnesses are being treated. Medical staff are doing what they can with limited resources. In the event of a flu outbreak, this will be a frontline unit for the most severe cases. In a dark corner, a museum piece The chief doctor explains the diodes show the old countrywide network of clinics still functioning. But if swine flu becomes more lethal, will the system be able to cope? Kyrgyzstan's public healthcare system has suffered for many years from underinvestment. Hospitals like this one are run down and short of equipment. Doctors' salaries are little more than a couple of hundred dollars a month. But despite the circumstances, international donors say Kyrgyzstan is doing everything it can to diagnose and detect the spread of swine flu. The Department of Health has warned that up to 30% of the Kyrgyz population could catch the H1N1 swine flu virus. This polyclinic is participating in the so-called Sentinel Detection System. Weekly updates from selected clinics feed into the World Health Organization's Regional Influenza Survey. With foreign aid, Kyrgyzstan now has two high-tech testing laboratories, and samples are increasingly showing up positive. But while there have only been a handful of suspected deaths from swine flu in Kyrgyzstan, vaccines won't be available until next month at the earliest. For Central Asia as a whole, experts are concerned about a general slowness to react and the lack of an integrated system. So far, neither Turkmenistan nor Tajikistan are sharing their figures. The stands have a poor history of talking to one another.
Compared with other regions, you could say that they're not at the same level of preparedness as others are. So in the end, these should have consequences for the population, because less preparedness means late detection. Late response, meaning that the healthcare system will not respond in time to save all the lives that they could save otherwise.
Kyrgyzstan appears to be better prepared than some of its neighbours to anticipate an epidemic. But it could well struggle with a virulent form. And if swine flu has not yet lived up to its initial grim expectations, at the very least, Central Asian countries are doing more to reform their creaking healthcare systems. Robin Forestier-Walker for Al Jazeera, Bishkek.